Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: death toll rises in South Africa as protests continue after the arrest of Jacob Zuma. US informant among those arrested in the assassination of Jovenel Moise in Haiti. Argentine Union calls for inquiry into Mauricio Macri government's arms supplies to Bolivian coup regime. And in our video section, we take a look at the recent crackdown by Israeli forces in the occupied West Bank. In our first story, at least 45 people have died amid the ongoing protests in South Africa. Unrest first spread after former President Jacob Zuma handed himself over to prison authorities on July 7th. The 79-year-old politician has been sentenced to 15 months in prison on charges of contempt of court. This was after he defied orders to give evidence in a corruption investigation into his 9-year presidential term. Zuma challenged his sentence during a court hearing on July 12th. However, a judgment on the matter has been reserved. In the meantime, protests and looting have continued in Zuma's home province of KwaZulu-Natal and Gauteng. Road blockades were first set up by his supporters in KZN on Friday. Protests soon spread to cities including Johannesburg and Durban and took the form of looting. Police forces have used rubber bullets and stun grenades to disperse crowds, and over 750 people have been arrested. Government officials have stated that most deaths have occurred due to stampedes. Meanwhile, vaccination sites were shut down in Gauteng and KZN on Monday. This was done just as South Africa faced its third and worst COVID wave. The current unrest is taking place against a backdrop of worsening inequality and rising inflation. The unemployment rate in the country grew to 32.6% in the first quarter of 2021. Poverty levels have also steadily widened since 2015. The results of a recent survey have shown that 20% of households experienced hunger in the last quarter of 2020. These long-standing issues have led to the specific form that the protests are taking. As reported by New Frame, the city of Durban is witnessing mass food riots and not just protests in support of Zuma. Supermarkets have become the primary target of looting, and massive amounts of food have been appropriated. By the morning of July 12th, over 200 shopping malls had reportedly been looted. Meanwhile, the military has deployed an additional 2,500 troops to Gauteng and KZN. In our next story, one of the Haitian American men arrested as a suspect in the assassination of Jovenel Moise is an alleged US informant. An official from the Drug Enforcement Administration told the Reuters news agency on July 12th. 55-year-old Joseph Vincent and 35-year-old James Solages were arrested by Haitian authorities last week. The DEA has not confirmed which of them was the informant. Meanwhile, a third person, Christian Emmanuel Sanon, was also arrested on July 11th. Authorities have alleged that he was a key figure in the assassination. Sanon is a pastor and holds a qualified medical license in Haiti. Police Chief Leon Charles stated that one of the suspects called Sanon after Moise had been killed. Charles further added that a hat with the US DEA logo, 20 boxes of bullets and gun parts were recovered from the house. Two cars and four license plates from the Dominican Republic were also found. Sanon was reportedly in contact with a US-based company called CTU Security. Authorities have stated that the company recruited the suspects in the killing. Sanon flew to Haiti in June and was accompanied by several of the hired gunmen. Authorities have stated that 28 people were involved in Moise's assassination. 18 Colombian and 3 Haitian mercenaries have been arrested so far. Another 5 are still at large and at least 3 have been killed. The Haitian-American suspects alleged that they had been hired to arrest Moise and not kill him. They also stated that they had been hired as translators for the Colombian mercenaries. Meanwhile, Colombian Defense Minister Diego Molano stated that the captured gunmen were retired members of the military. However, a journalist has reported that at least 6 are active army personnel and 2 are sergeants. We now go to Argentina, where trade unions have demanded an inquiry into the administration of former President Mauricio Macri. This follows news that his government supplied non-lethal weapons and ammunition to Bolivian coup leaders. The news was made public by Bolivian Foreign Minister Rogelio Maita on July 8th. He showed a letter addressed to the Argentine ambassador from a former head of the Bolivian Air Force. The letter thanked the ambassador for the delivery of 40,000 cartridges, tear gas and gas grenades. It was dated November 13, 2019, just 3 days after the coup that ousted progressive President Evo Morales. Defense Minister Edmundo Novillo also confirmed this weekend that the ANES regime had authorized the entry of Argentine military and paramilitary personnel. The Central Union of Argentine Workers, or CTAs, argued that Macri knew of the coup against Morales in advance. Foreign Minister Maita also denounced the complicity of the Macri administration in the violent suppression of protests. In particular, he pointed to the massacres in Sacaba on November 15th and Sencata on November 19th. People had taken to the streets to protest the coup regime of Jeanine Anez. In retaliation, security forces opened fire, killing a total of 27 people and injuring several others. In total, at least 36 people were killed by the Anez regime during the 2009 coup. The CTA argued that the role of the Macri government in this violence places them within the framework of crimes against humanity. Meanwhile, a Ministry of Security report revealed that the amount of arms and ammunition sent by the government exceeded what was mentioned in the letter. The deputy of the Movement Towards Socialism party has stated that a parliamentary commission will be formed to look into the matter. And for our final story, we look at the ongoing crackdown in the occupied West Bank. Protests against the custodial killing of activist Nisar Banat have been heavily repressed by Israel-Palestinian Authority forces. Meanwhile, Israeli forces have carried out a series of raids and arrests. The headquarters of the Union of Agricultural Workers Committee was raided and sealed on July 7th. On the same day, the executive director of the Union Health Work Committees was also detained. Here is a video feature on the ongoing repression in the West Bank.
On Wednesday, July 7th, Israeli forces launched a series of violent raids across the West Bank. Heavily armed Israeli soldiers raided the headquarters of the Union of Agricultural Workers Committees, UAWC, in Adbire, outside of Ramallah. They seized computers and sealed the entrance and ordered its closure under military notice for 6 months. Israeli forces also arrested 11 activists, including prominent Palestinian healthcare expert and the executive director of the Union of Health Work Committees, UHWC, Dr. Shatha Odeh. The UHWC itself faced a similar raid on June 9th and was also closed under military notice. The People's Health Movement condemned Dr. Odeh's arrest in the strongest terms and demanded her immediate, unconditional release. Dr. Odeh and the UHWC are at the forefront of demanding equitable treatment and better services for Palestinians under occupation. Student activist from Bir Zeit University, Layan Nasser, was also arrested on Wednesday, July 7th. The latest crackdown against activists and civil society organizations in Palestine has been met with sharp condemnation from organizations within Palestine and internationally. The International People's Assembly released a statement on July 9th condemning the repressive action against the UAWC. The international platform stated, "We stand in solidarity with UAWC and with the Palestinian struggle for liberation." The Landless Rural Workers Movement of Brazil, MST, also condemned the closure of UAWC, their partner organization in Palestine. UAWC committees in Gaza organized a protest to reject the closure of the office in Albire. The UAWC is an internationally recognized organization and part of international networks like the Via Campesina. Following Israel's bombardment of Gaza in early May, the organization launched a campaign along with La Via Campesina to support small farmers, fishers, and others in the food production sector in Gaza. They highlighted that the bombing campaign caused around $27 million in damages, including greenhouses, agricultural lands, and poultry farms. Despite the shutdowns, the UAWC, the UHWC, and the other Palestinian people's movements and organizations that have been targeted in these repressive actions have vowed to continue their work.
That's all we have time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.